If you don't look at the news, you wouldn't even know something's happening outside.
This is one of the best places on the planet that I can be.
And especially in the lockdowns, because I feel that you treat us so well, like for improve our immune system. So I'm just blessing and say thank you every day, every day.
Although I was not planning to be at the ashram during the lockdown, during this period for so long, I feel it's a blessing in disguise.
The ashram, the way it's handled the lockdown is, it hasn't just handled the lockdown, the ashram handles life.
Just the precision and the way Sadhguru has planned everything. And
care that they have taken to make sure that, you know, everybody in the ashram is safe is really remarkable.
You know, there's always somebody to care about your well-being in a much, much deeper way that you can possibly understand.
As far as the safety with Anisha, I have felt incredibly safe.
We ensured that nobody could come in or go out of the yoga center during the lockdown period.
Sadhguru had a few meetings with us regarding the situation, and he put us all on high alert to ensure that this does not come into the yoga center.
We started taking many precautions since January 2020. We started with creating awareness about maintaining social distance, following respiratory etiquette among the ashramites and guests. Many posters and reminders were also circulated. We have been working closely with the local public health authorities since January onwards.
And they really appreciated the way we are meticulously following to maintain the hygiene. They found people so energetic, nobody was in a fear or turmoil or anything. So they were really surprised, and they were telling that it is only possible that Sadhguru can give such a kind of guidance.
Since the lockdown started, all of us have been going through periodic medical screening, and it is being continued till date.
As far as the medical screening is concerned, there are just three simple steps. When the individual comes to the counter, their temperature is checked and their details are captured. Once the details are entered in the app, their symptoms are asked for. If they do not have any of the symptoms in the checklist, they are given a health wristband.
So in case anyone was found without a wristband, the security personnel usually gently probe them to come for the medical screening. So no medical screening, no food. That's how it is here at the ashram.
We have reorganized the living spaces and workspaces to maintain social distancing. Dining space have been shifted to open area to maintain social distancing.
We got in touch with the local farmers around ashram. Once we contacted them, they were more than willing to come forward and help us. They delivered their vegetables, everything at the ashram premises itself. We have a separate area where vegetables, fruits, everything, we sanitize it, and from here we take it to the kitchen.
நம்ம சேவாதாரர்ஸ் எல்லாரும் பாத்தீங்கன்னா காலையில வந்து குளிச்சிட்டு தான் உள்ள வருவாங்க. கம்பல்சரி டெய்லியுமே அவங்களுக்கு வந்து டெம்பரேச்சர் எவ்வளவு இருக்குன்னு செக் பண்ணுவோம். அதுக்கு அடுத்து அவங்க க்ளவுஸ், மாஸ்க் இதெல்லாம் போட்டுட்டு குக்கிங் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுவாங்க. அடுத்து டைனிங், வயசானவங்க அவங்கள வந்து ஒரு இடத்துல சாப்பிட்ற மாதிரியும், குழந்தைங்க எல்லாம் வந்து ஒரு இடத்துல சாப்பிட்ற மாதிரியும், மித்த நார்மலாக இருக்கிறவங்க ஒரு இடத்துல சாப்பிட்றது, அது மூணு டைனிங்கை பிரித்தோம். மெயினாக அந்த இடத்துல வந்து நம்ம சமூக இடைவெளி, சோசியல் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் வந்து 6 feet மெயின்டைன் பண்ணுறது. அதுக்கு ஒரு சிலருக்கு ஞாபகப்படுத்துறதுக்காக வாலண்டியர்ஸோட சப்போர்ட் வச்சு ஒரு ஃப்ளக் கார்டு மாதிரி இருக்கும்.
The same has been done with Sadhana area as well. Hand sanitizers were made available everywhere in the ashram premises. Disinfectant spraying has been done on a daily basis.
So the maintenance department, they form a team. In a day, they'll go to different places, including our stay area, and the office, and the kitchen, and wherever the people are moving around. All those areas have been taken into consideration.
Apart from these, the elderly population has been separated from the rest of the population to protect themselves.
How they took the age that was more vulnerable and putting them also separate from us was incredibly, just, it gives me goosebumps.
So all entry and exit points to the yoga center was closed and only one gate was operational. So this way we could maintain a very tight control on movement of people and material. Every vehicle that is coming into the yoga center and every material that is coming into the yoga center was completely sanitized. Security team were deployed at every point to ensure that safe and social distancing was maintained within the yoga center.
We have been fortunate to receive guidelines from Sadhguru to improve our immunity. Along with the practices we do, we have been doing certain yogic practices to improve the lung capacity and specific processes like applying vibhuti over the body.
I feel like I've grown a lot being here in the past 70-something days.
Every single day I've been able to practice yoga and meditation, which of course is also supporting my immunity and health.
We chew the neem leaves and keep the juice in the mouth for 1 to 2 hours. We consume turmeric, amla on a regular basis. We also take Nilavembu Kashayam twice a day and herbal drinks made with concoction of some herbs to improve our immunity.
I think there is a concrete sense of responsibility in the ashram, a real sense of responsibility, recognizing that you are responsible for who you are, what you do, and your way of life.
Sometimes I feel that I'm living in another, not even country, I'm living in another planet.
So every detail has been really thought through, planned out, and acted upon, more importantly.
So the kind of responsibility that people have over here and just the organizational agility to be ahead of the game and make sure everything is on the top, it's just phenomenal. It blows my mind.
There's an energy here that keeps you safe in another dimension altogether.
I was kind of losing hope in humanity, and then comes Sadhguru, and he's doing so much for the world and helping people, helping the environment, and just brings you hope that there is someone doing something good in the world.
So having Sadhguru here has been a huge privilege for all of us. His presence and his constant guidance has made it so easy for us to go through such a challenging situation in the most effortless and joyful way.
We are working together to make this Isha Yoga Center a safe haven and a COVID-free environment.